Welcome back. In this video, we will go over the skeleton of the hand. The skeleton of the hand consists of three groups of bones. First, we have the carpals right here. The second group, we have the metacarpals. And the third group, we have the phalanges right here. Starting with the first group, the carpals, we have 8 carpal bones in each hand. All carpal bones, they are short in shape. The 8 carpal bones, they are arranged in 2 rows. The proximal row, which articulates with the radius and the ulna at the wrist joint, and the distal row, which articulates with the metacarpal bones. Starting with the first carpal bone, right here, this is the trapezium. Next to the trapezium, we have the trapezoid. A way to remember the trapezium, right here, the word trapezium, it has an M in it. This is the thumb. The word thumb also it has an M in it. So the trapezium is at the base of the thumb. Next to the trapezium, we have the trapezoid. The trapezoid is at the base of the index finger. Moving to the third bone, which is the capitate. The capitate is at the base of the middle finger right here. Moving to the fourth bone, which is the hamate. Notice how the hamate, it carries 2 fingers on it. This is the ring finger and this is the little finger. Moving to the proximal row, right here we have the scaphoid bone. The scaphoid bone articulates with the trapezium, trapezoid, and also the capitate. Next to the trapezoid, we have the lunate. The lunate on this side, it looks like half a moon. That's the lunate. Next to the lunate, we have right here, this is the triquatrium. Next to the triquatrium, we have the pisiform right here. So let's repeat the carpal bones. This is the trapezium, that is the trapezoid. This is the capitate. This is the hamate. That is the scaphoid. This is the lunate. That is the triquatrium, and this is the pisiform. You can remember the triquatrium is trying her best to lift the pisiform right on top, right here. Also, the scaphoid, in a way, it looks like an S, right here. Moving to the second group, the metacarpals. We have 5 metacarpals in each hand. They are numbered 1 to 5, starting from the thumb to the little finger. So this is metacarpal number 1, this is metacarpal number 3, that's metacarpal number 5. All the metacarpal bones are long bones in shape. They have 2 ends and a shaft. The metacarpals, they articulate with the carpals at the proximal right here through the bases of the metacarpals, and the metacarpals, they articulate with the phalanges at the heads right here. This is the head. A fun fact, if you make a fist, the knuckles right here, these are the heads of the metacarpals. So these right here, we have the metacarpals. Right here, we have 2 rows of carpals. Also, right here, the carpals. Right here, you have the metacarpals. And these are the third group, the phalanges. Moving to the third group, the phalanges. We have 14 phalanges in each hand. Each finger contains 3 phalanges. This is a proximal phalanx. Proximal because it is closer to the point of attachment of the upper extremity. This is the middle phalanx and this is the distal phalanx. Except for the thumb has only 2 phalanges. This is the proximal phalanx and this is the distal phalanx. All the phalanges, they are long bones in shape. We have 2 ends and a shaft. 2 ends and a shaft, also 2 ends and a shaft. When the upper extremity is in the anatomical position, the thumb is the lateral finger and the little finger is the medial finger. Based on that, the ulna, which is the medial bone, toward the medial aspect of the hand, and we'll have the radius, the lateral bone, toward the lateral aspect of the hand. I am sure you found the video helpful. hit the like button and subscribe for more amazing content.